today's topic. You're on the air.
Yeah, you're right. Cars should be forced to share the road and bike.
Yeah, and cyclists should remember roads were built for bikes in the first place. It's going to take time for everybody to get along.
Let me tell you a story, okay? One time, I ran a red light
on my bike, and there happened to be a cop on the corner. I wasn't paying attention. He pulls me over with his little finger.
He says, here, have a nice day. He gives me a $50 ticket. That's a true story, okay? So, I wish there were more cops on corners.
He offends people on both sides, and plus he's hilarious.
I'm just not a big fan of Cinco de Blends, but I am a big fan of your coffee, Sam. Thank you.
You're too nice, Leah Townsend.
Character.
Relieved.
Jody Bellarusso. She's strong but feminine. Knows what she wants, isn't afraid to go for it. She's my kind of gal.
I'm so glad you like her. Because the way I made the story flow.
Quick question. I have no idea what this book is about. Do you?
Of course I do.
Oh, well, that's a relief because that is not reflected in these pages. There's no zilch. It's just 310 pages of rainbows. Leah, your first book came so easy. What's going on?
Well, remember, I was writing about myself. I'm a senator's daughter, and Kathleen is a senator's daughter. And, you know, I took experiences from my childhood and I guess made a few tweaks.
You think what you use the...
I guess I'm just having a wee bit of trouble with a character that's so different.
Come on, don't get all demure on me. You're an insightful and gifted writer. Now, a book needs conflict, it needs struggle, it needs a character who confronts everyone who gets in her way.
She does struggle in her way.
Well, I need Jody Bellarusso to struggle my way, and fast. I'm gonna give it to you straight. You're down to 4 weeks. Here's your manuscript. And here are some thoughts that the marketing department and I have come up with. Don't look so worried, it's only a couple of chapters. Margaret, where's my salad?
Like to have
please.
Excellent choice.
Actually, I'd like the crepes, Suzanne.
Do you mean those flaming pancakes?
Yeah, doesn't that look fun?
What a spectacle.
The Dover sole is fine.
Are you sure? I mean, have what you want.
Oh, no, yeah. It's always good here.
You did not!
Yes, I did. Crepe Suzette's, just like you said.
What? Were they as good as mine?
I don't know.
You went back to the Dover sole only, don't be such a doormat. What is your problem?
My problem is I have nothing to wear, and I need to look good for Edward's reception tonight.
Well, you always look good, and he won't notice what you're wearing anyway.
You're right. I spent the last 2 hours laying out wardrobe when I should be writing, because I can't come up with conflict for my main character. Because we don't have any. We don't argue about anything at all. I love Edward. He's great. He's just...
boring? Mm-hmm. You're bored? You feel boring when you're with him, and that makes him bored?
Not at all. We're perfect for each other. We've been together 2 years.
You know what you need? Something that he will notice.
Do you like it?
That is some red dress.
Are you okay?
Yes, yeah, no, I'm fine.
Is it too much? It's too much. I can go change. Do you want me to change?
So we will have to go with it.
Okay. Well, if you're sure.
I am.
Okay.
Okay?
Okay.
Empty, dear. I'll get you another drink.
Oh, no, don't worry about it. I can get it. You need to talk to your professor friends. Go ahead.
Dr. McKinley.
Thank you.
apologize for not calling before coming over.
No, I think it's great that you did something spontaneous. Wow! What's going on?
Aren't you gonna read the card?
I want to do everything to make us work, and I know you want to make it work too, XO. 20% off 4-week course in conflict management, paid in full.
I thought this is perfect. You know, conflict is harder for some more than it is for others.
Yes. What does this have to do with us?
Well, you know, things were a little awkward the other night, and you have been saying how much trouble you're having with the character in your book.
Yeah, that was really nothing.
But no, it got me thinking. You know, maybe we should learn to deal with conflict in a proactive life. What do you say?
I guess if you think this will help us.
Great! Okay, good. Right, first session is tonight. Address is right here in the coupon. I have to run to work. This is going to be so good. You'll see. I am so excited.
Because the wife has a hard time keeping her...
If one actually did the things he said he was going to do, I wouldn't have to repeat myself 1 million times.
Okay, Robert, Glenda, that's why you're here. This is actually perfect. Okay.
Oh, hi, I'm Ernie, and I'm so happy to be here.
And why are you here?
Oh, that's an excellent question. On my last performance review, it was noted that I have the tendency...
Not to worry, we can help you with that.
Great.
I'm sorry?
I'm Carol. I would like people to listen to me.
I think that's an excellent decision, Carol. So that just leaves you.
I'm Leah Townsend, so I don't know why I'm here.
Okay, well, maybe we can start with Edward Krause and why you think he should be here.
Edward is my second cousin, and this was really all his idea, so...
Your second cousin signed you both up for conflict management group?
Yeah. Okay, so why do you suppose he's not here?
Well, you know, he really hasn't been... kidney surgery.
Oh, wish him a speedy recovery. Okay, so before we begin, I just have a little bit of housekeeping here. So, Ernie, it says here that you did not pay for the class.
What? No, I paid online. Who said I didn't pay?
Kidney surgery, that's a pretty serious procedure. Did you know that?
Mm-hmm. You know, Ernie, I have to report all your actions to your supervisor.
Since when?
Well, you know what? If you have a receipt, then we can clear this up right now.
That was nice of you. Does it still hurt? A little bit right here.
Yes, but I think we should be listening.
That's so funny because, you know, your kidneys are back here. Should be hurting there.
Right.
No, I don't have the receipt.
Well, I guess that's a lesson in it.
What?
You see, conflict will almost always take us by surprise. It's not something you can plan for. See, Ernie here, he didn't realize his actions would result in conflict.
Hey, I don't like being made to look stupid.
Too late.
Hey, maybe you should stay out of this.
Are you threatening my wife?
Hey, guys, it's Conflict Management Group. Remember? I'm sure Ernie didn't mean anything by it.
It's okay, guys. Why don't you have a seat? Conflict can be.
That was a stunt?
Yes, it was. Thank you very much, Ernie. You can sit down.
Was that too much? Is it kind of fell? Yeah? Okay.
So this is very interesting. So, Glenda, you deal with conflict by using sarcasm. And Robert, you take conflict by the horns. And Cinco, I was very impressed. You really jumped in there, but just be careful, because Carol, like you were ready to flee the scene. It's okay, we'll work on that. And Leah, judging by the look on your face, you look like you'd rather get a root canal than deal with conflict, am I right?
I just think everybody should be able to get along.
Hear, hear.
Okay, well, I'm very happy that you guys are all here. So why don't we start off with the first exercise?
Leah! Oh, you didn't call.
Sorry about that. Where were you?
Excuse me?
The flowers, the coupon, the class, that was tonight.
Yes, I know. How did it go? Please tell me it was helpful for you.
I thought you got it to be helpful for us, not just me.
I don't have a problem with conflict.
Neither do I. I don't.
Leah, the fact that you came all the way over here tonight to tell me how you really feel is a really big step for you. I think this is going to be really good for you. Okay, think of it as an investment in our relationship. I mean, I know that I am committed to doing whatever it takes to make this work. Aren't you?
Yes, sure. Of course I am.
Okay, so this next exercise is called Address and Accept. Strong opinion. The other one has to just accept and respond honestly, but without challenging or fear. Let's start with Cinco and Leah. Okay, Leah, you can start.
I just can't think of anything.
Okay. All right. Okay, so, Singer, you can start.
I think you need this class more than anyone else in here. Respectfully.
What do you think of it?
I think that he doesn't actually know me, and how could he possibly make a comment like that?
Okay, that's good. Tell Cinco, not me.
You know what? No. I think my cousin Edward made a mistake and didn't know what kind of class this was, but I'm sorry, but I think I'm wasting everybody's time.
Okay, but don't leave.
Problem? You know what? Maybe you have a problem with your nice voice and calm demeanor, and maybe it's all just a front, and maybe you don't know how to deal with anything at all, ever.
It's fantastic. Great work. But say it to Cinco, not to me. What she's experiencing right now is called misplaced anger. It's very, very common. You can just have a seat. Let's have Robert and Ernie up next.
For what it's worth, Professor, I entirely concur with your assessment.
Thank you. That actually sounded sincere.
And I would hate to have you turn that piercing insight on me.
Hear me out. First, I don't have any conflict in my life. Edward and I have literally have not had one single argument. Plus, you know what? I don't even like to hurt people. I don't like to hurt people's feelings. But what does she know about misplaced anger? What anger? I'm not going back to that class. Wait.
Okay, so she claims she had... I tell her, I think she needs this class more than anybody else in there.
That is so weird. He is talking about his group, and so are you.
I really don't think I need to be here.
So, folks, obviously I beg to differ. Now, I'm not gonna name names because I'm not that kind of guy.
Did I just say that out loud? I think I did.
Okay, here's the point. Here's what I want to say. I think this class is a great thing for people who have conflict issues of all.
When did you start listening to this nut?
Well, since you told me that he was in your group, it is you, right? It's all for show.
My question is this. Why is it so difficult for us to face the truth about ourselves?
Mm-hmm.
Someone so convinced they do not have issues with conflict. Get this.
She then, instead of doing the exercise to the teacher, goes right after her. She lets her have it now. Right.
She's got no conflict issues whatsoever, none. She's good to go. It's a question that is on my mind, callers. And I want to hear from you.
What are you doing?
Cinco D, you're on the air.
Well, I...
Okay, listen to your name.
Jody. Jody Bellarusa.
Jody. Hi, Jody.
What do you think of my confused Madam X?
You know what? Maybe that girl doesn't belong in the group. Maybe you just love conflict so much that you thrive on it. And you've become like this conflict vampire. And then when you're attracted to someone who doesn't have the same conflict issues, you get uneasy and defensive. What do you really feel?
What makes you say I'm attracted to her?
Jody,
wow.
We lost
it's too bad that you couldn't say that as yourself.
I think I made my point clear enough. You should take this.
We're going to be right back after this break.
I'm glad you can make it. Your mother said you were trying...
Douglas, I said she was working on her book.
I would never cancel any debt.
Good girl.
Douglas, what did the doctor say? No salt. He also said, avoid stressful situations. And I caught him listening to the Cinco Dublin show today.
No, you should really listen to your doctor.
The kid's a fool.
Your doctor is about 70 years old.
No, Dublin is outrageous. I'm just like his old man. Father of his devoted his entire newspaper career to attacking every stand that I took.
Douglas, don't exaggerate.
I believe in a good, solid middle of the road. And if I was a little bit to the left of an issue, he claimed I was too liberal. And I had 1 foot to the right, he claimed I was too conservative. I mean, is that fair to me, Leah?
Me? Well, I think whatever his father did while it's between you and Dublin Senior, it doesn't really have anything to do with Cinco.
Leah, I'm surprised. I mean, did you hear the broadcast?
Yes, dear. We all heard the broadcast. It wasn't that bad.
You agree with that, Leah?
I'm sure it was an outrage.
Good, exactly. At least I can count on someone for the truth.
Hope you're...
Yes, of course I am.
I remember the last book. You wore the same pair of sweatpants for days.
Well, that was because the washing machine was broken. Mm-hmm. Have you ever had flaming baggage?
You mean Krebs is that? Many times.
And Daddy wasn't embarrassed.
Oh, never with your father.
So have you always done whatever? Yeah, see, I keep trying to spice things up with Edward by suggesting we try new things, and he looks at me as if I've said we should rob a bank.
It's called a relationship, Leah. It has ebbs and flows. It can't always be smooth sailing.
So it took me a couple of days to kick in, but then wait, and writing all this conflict, it really kicks up the drama, and it's exciting. I'm excited about the revisions. I'm almost done.
No.
No?
No. Yes, now there is some conflict in Jody's life, but it's not handled right.
Is she too aggressive now?
Sweetie, I'm going to read you something straight from the dictionary. Conflict, to come into collision or disagreement, a struggle or in... There's no clash. Everything happens in her head. She doesn't do anything.
She will, JR. She will. I'm not going to let you down. I can rewrite as much as you want. Besides, wasn't it Hemingway that said a good novel should take at least 10 years?
Hemingway didn't have a huge advance he might have had to pay back.
second chance. Like I do with people.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I suppose I have conflict with the buyers I deal with. The people I consider friends. What about you?
I really have no conflict in my life. In fact, my publisher says I have no conflict in my new book, which, I mean, there is, but apparently it's not the right kind.
What about the father-daughter relationship in your first book? Wasn't that based on your life?
No, I'm not that character. I mean, I would never do anything to disappoint or embarrass my father.
Easy, carefree relationship with him, or is it because you avoid conflict?
It's pretty breezy.
Excuse me, I want to say something. I'm rereading your old book, as you know, and it's got a little Victorian plotting in it, but once you get past that, it seems like it's written from the heart. So now you're saying you want to rewrite the conflict to pander to your publisher.
I'm not pandering, and that's not even what pandering means. I didn't say it. By the way, can we remember for a moment that you don't actually know me?
I know that I'm not a doormat for a publisher or a father.
Thanks, Ernie. Really, because many believe that most men have unresolved issues with their fathers.
I'm not most men. I've heard your show. What's that supposed to mean?
Well, your dad is a respected man in this city. You're an entertainer. He's a political journalist.
Jock, jock.
Okay, loud and fast, without thinking about it, I want you to tell me a source of your conflict. Go.
Bullies. Pretty much everyone I work with.
Her.
Him. Excellent, excellent. Okay, so let's go play conflict snakes and ladders.
I didn't mean to upset you.
Not at all. It's not a big deal. You're just a know-it-all.
I call him as I see him.
Maybe you need some glasses.
Maybe, but there are certain things I see clearly.
In my opinion, this is a crisis that everyone in this country, not just us here today, needs to pay attention to. Should your education cost more than a sedan or two? When I was a student here, I just had to pay for books and, you know, party favors. Today, it's out of control. We're good in a minute, but right now, I want to hear from you guys. How do you think? What do you feel?
There's no class until 10.
Hello.
Leah. What's wrong?
Nothing's wrong. I wanted to surprise you before your morning class.
Oh, great. Yeah, no, that I'm so glad you did.
Yeah, me too. Here, muffins. And I have coffee, fresh from Sam's coffee truck. Coffee? So, what are you lecturing on today?
Amanda Heisenberg's theory.
Oh. That sounds interesting.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
The theory is that during quantum experiments, there is a seemingly unavoidable tendency of humans to influence any given situation, just as you have influenced this situation.
Watching the broadcast a few minutes ago. What brings you here?
I was here to see my cousin, but I was just leaving.
Edward?
Yeah. He's a professor here, and it's his first week back at work, and I just wanted to see if he settled in okay.
That was very considerate of you.
Yeah, thank you.
You're welcome. I want to apologize for if I offended you at last class.
Don't be. There's really no need. I'm fine.
Next class, I'm going to make an effort to be a little more sensitive, and I feel like I'm learning.
That's very generous, but I won't be going back to class. I'm really behind on my book, and if I don't turn it in like yesterday...
That's really too bad. Kind of like you, Leah Townsend. Now I'm gonna have to bond with Carol, so she scares me, I gotta tell you. And, I'm gonna try to be gentler on my next review.
Edward? Hey.
What?
Oh, what's all this?
You know, I was so taken with your spontaneous work that I wanted to reciprocate.
Are those student papers?
My advanced class. I thought what fun it would be for you and I to spend the evening reviewing them together.
Edward, I need to apologize for barging in on you this morning. It was really a silly idea.
Yeah, it really was unlike you.
Unlike me?
Why would it be good to be unlike you?
Right. Sorry.
Listen, why don't you order a pizza? If we start now, we could be finished all this by 11.
You know what? I forgot. I have my group tonight.
Tonight?
Yeah. I hope you're not terribly disappointed.
Well, then.
It's a process.
Oh, wow. You know, I'm so glad that you are getting what you need from it.
I am.
Well, okay.
Sorry, I'm late. Oh, is it over? We're going on a field trip.
Well, this is a nice surprise.
I think I was in. No, I came to avoid it.
Okay, so I'm going to split you up into teams of two. Thought it would be fun if we added a little competition. And the winner gets a gift card to Mangalo's. Okay, everybody choose a color.
That place is impossible to get in. It's so hot. We should team up, okay?
Now, the objective of this exercise is to stall in the line as long as you can. So I want you to feel the heat of the conflict rising around you because you're holding up the line. Got it? Go. What is it?
Oh, yes, you do, partner. Haggle the cashier for 10 cents, claiming you were shortchanged. Partner two, escalate the situation by becoming agitated and claim to be in a rush. I'll take that one. Easy.
Cinco Dublin just got chosen for the losing team.
I don't think so. I never lose when there's a prize at stake.
There's a first time for everything.
No, I don't think so.
$0.30.
Leah Townsend, is that you?
Wow, Mrs. Musgrave, what are you doing back in town?
Well, we moved back. Didn't your mother tell you?
No. I hear your novel is doing great.
Okay, let's not write a novel right now and keep things moving, shall we?
You're not listening. One of us has to go get another item to hold up the line.
You always do this. Jimmy, I have a prejudice.
Louder. She can't hear you.
May I have a prejudice?
Carol, you can do it.
It was very nice to see you.
Or maybe we could do a ladies' brunch.
That would be perfect.
That's wonderful. Let's pull out our calendars and set a date for brunch right now. Yeah. Yeah?
Robert, when you address each other, I want you to use phrases like, I feel... instead of you.
Fine.
Excuse me. Your change?
If we were moving any slower, I'd be frozen in time.
I'm sorry. I think you shorted me 10 cents.
Come on, lady.
I just counted it. Did you drop it? Nope.
Item from the frozen food section, which is way over on the other side of the grocery store, would buy us more time than the produce, which is right here.
And I'm feeling like you're telling me what to do.
Just let me help him first, then. Oh, no, I can't wait for that. I need my dime right now.
Lady, it's a dime. Let it go.
Okay, fine. Ode, and I cannot let the store cheat me out of what is rightfully mine.
Okay. I'm sorry for being so bossy.
Apology accepted. Frozen peas it is. Nicely done, thank you.
Carol, you can do it.
Have a price check on that. If you don't have time to check the price, it's fine. I mean, if I were doing your job, I would be checking every price.
And maybe a price comparison, too.
Yes. We want to make sure we get the best deal.
On those peppers. Lady, come on. Let her check me out, and then you can have your print going gray.
Maybe you can take this 10 cents, and things are just going to work out just fine.
Yeah, you know what, Lady? That's very nice of you, but this woman does not deserve to be bailed out.
It's just, if you must know, right before my favorite uncle died, he gave me this really old dime, and, you know, dimes just have a very special meaning to me since that day and years, and I should be over it, but 10, like a dime. See, that, it's wow. Oh, okay, well, thank you.
I feel so bad about your favorite dead uncle. That was just genius.
It was absolutely ridiculous. It was the only thing I could come up with that wouldn't give me lockup for being certifiably in there.
Yes, I was. We made a great team.
Okay, everybody, very, very good work today. You all took a major step forward in confronting conflict in a very public way. You should all be very proud of yourself.
Thanks, and I hand over the prize so I can take my wife to the fanciest restaurant in town.
Well, according to my timing, Cinco and Leah actually won.
They won? How is that possible?
It's possible by 4 seconds.
You know, I really don't ever have time to eat, like ever, so why don't you take it?
Oh, just guys, before you go, I have a field assignment for you. So staying in the same teams, I want you guys to go and confront the person you have the most conflict with. Engage with them and pay attention to what it is about them that triggers it in you.
When do we do it?
Both team members have to have it done by next week, so come on, let's go ahead and go ahead.
Well, I'm not sure why you're not excited. Can't be me, so it must be because you heard the place stinks.
No, actually, I heard the place is amazing.
Oh, so then.
I guess we could do lunch.
We could do lunch tomorrow. That's the kind of homework.
I see.
Hi. Shouldn't you be at work?
Yes, but this can't wait. Leah, I'm sorry things have been so strained between us lately. I know I've been busy and you've been stressed out about your book.
Yeah, a little bit.
Yeah, it takes me a while to catch on sometimes, but I get it. And I think I know what you need right now.
Really?
You know, I know your old desktop has been acting up, and you would never actually go and buy one yourself. So, this morning on my way to work, I decided, what the heck? And, well, here you are.
That's really sweet. Thank you.
Now, I really must get to campus, but one more thing. I'm taking you to lunch on Saturday.
You mean the laptop?
I'll email you the details. So, what are you up to today?
You know, just locked away in here, writing.
Then I won't keep you. I'll see you Saturday.
Hello.
How's it going?
He's not here. Maybe he's not coming. Is it wrong to hope he forgot?
Why are you so nervous?
Because my boyfriend just bought me a new laptop this morning, and now I'm sitting in a restaurant waiting for another man.
Relax. It's just a lunch. It's not like it's a date. Right?
He's here. I gotta go.
Sorry, I'm late.
Hi. You look...
reservations? We have these guys.
Oh, you know what? I thought I had mine, but I don't.
Whoa. I'm sure that's not gonna matter. Will that matter?
Of course not.
It's not a date.
I'm sorry?
I hear the food's great.
You know, you baffle me a little bit. I
don't know why a woman like you is in any way unsure of herself.
A woman like me? What does that mean?
You're very, very funny, and you don't know you're funny, which makes you even funnier.
I don't think anybody's ever called me funny before.
I think you're Riot. And, you're really, really pretty. And you have an effect on me.
I think when two people have things in common, it helps one to see things in one's own.
You are the last person I can imagine having something in common with.
Oh, really? We're both very smart. We both like to reach a lot of people. You're prettier than I am. But, you know, we both have father issues.
I don't.
Really? Marilyn led us right there, and you don't want to admit that? Well, I admit it. I have father issues.
Was your father tough?
Brilliant. Passionate.
So what's the problem between you two?
We only argue. So, we don't talk.
Have you ever thought about using a different tactic with him?
Like what?
Have you ever thought of hugging him?
I'm sorry, a hug? Clearly you have never met my father.
No. But think about it for a second. The next time he goes into his usual...
attack mode?
Instead of barking back, try to defuse it.
With a hug?
Yeah. A real hug, a metaphorical hug, any kind of hug you would like.
All right. I'll make that my field assignment.
That's a good choice.
Are you free Saturday morning?
You want to confront your family?
He doesn't believe in weekends. He never did. So, we're fine. How about you? Is there a conversation you want to have with a certain senator that I could be present at?
That would be a very light and breezy conversation, so he's definitely not my assignment.
Okay. How about Edward?
Edward? What do you mean, Edward?
Well, whenever Edward's name comes up, you get a little agitated, so I'm thinking you're not dealing with Edward, your second cousin.
No, as I've said before, and often, I don't have any problems with Edward. And besides, anyways, he's on a skiing trip.
Wow. New kidney working that well, huh?
Yep, that side of the family has amazing recuperative skills.
Ah, well. How about your side?
But I haven't been feeling so great the last few minutes, so I think I should probably go.
Can I give you a ride home?
No, I have a car.
Is there really an Edward?
Do you think I signed myself up for a conflict management course and then changed my mind and then made up a fake relative?
Yes, I do, because you're one of those people who doesn't have the heart to hurt anyone's...
That's very sweet, but not very accurate. Excuse me.
And I just need someone to explain it to me. This
Venus versus Mars equation.
I am so tired of trying to crack that code. I'm at lunch with a very attractive, very interesting, intelligent woman. And
although it wasn't technically a date, although it was
starting to feel a nice banter going back and forth.
She asks me a whole bunch of questions. And I ask her some questions. And bam! Out of nowhere, she makes up an obviously fake excuse and storms out.
Can someone run that through the
opposite sex app for me, please, and translate?
Please make up this dance between the sexes.
Caller, you're on the air.
Enlighten me, please.
Hello? You're on the air, but not for much longer.
This is Jody. Jody Bellarusa.
Jody, hi. You sound familiar.
Well, you know, I'm a regular caller.
Okay.
You know, you're a lot to handle. You're very, very direct. And while admirable, that can put some people off. Some things are personal and private. And maybe you need to learn to keep some questions to yourself. Maybe that's what this person was thinking when she decided to leave.
Leah, is that you? Leah, if you have something to say to me, just go ahead and say it. I'm
assignment this morning.
No, we don't. We do today.
We do. So can we do it now, please?
No. I need shoes.
Jody Bellarusso, why do you keep calling into my show with somebody else?
Am I somebody that you're afraid to be in conflict with?
No. I suppose it's because, as Leah Townsend, I always say and do the right thing, and I really didn't want to say the right thing to you. Are you mad?
Listen, my audience got a sneak peek at the spike, and now my producer wants to make it a regular thing.
What? I cannot. Are you kidding?
I'm kidding.
His radio show. You did sabotage my radio show. You called in, and on the air, he took down my whole argument. It's called a debate. Google it.
Sorry.
All right, look, I got a plane to Boston in an hour. What do you want? Fine. What's the topic?
Nothing. Just, you know, talk. Breezy conversation?
We don't do breezy conversation.
That's true. You know, I knew it. This was a waste of time.
Yeah, for some hotshot who's made a successful career out of talking all the time, you're awfully quiet. So why don't we just agree that nothing has been added or dropped, and we can both get on with it. Leah. Yes, I'm going to presume that you're in a position to tell me what's actually going on here.
Well, sir, I believe I'm here to remind Cinco that you can't avoid some things forever.
Challenging me to be the best man I can be. I love you too, kid.
You haven't said a word in about 6 blocks.
I could not have done that without you.
I really didn't do anything. I mean, you would have confronted him no matter who your partner was.
Yeah, but you had the idea to give him a hug. It was the right idea. You have a very unique perspective on dealing with conflict. Not everyone shares it, but more people should.
It's just about being honest.
I'm on a roll here, okay? Who are you in conflict with? Let's go see them right now.
Sure, this book is just all-consuming. I gotta go.
Thank you again, Leah. I mean it.
It was my plan. I'll do my thing soon. I just have to figure out where I'm going. Oh, no.
Bad news?
Oh, no. Sorry.
Hey.
Hi. Thanks, but actually, we've never been here before.
Wow, how did you get reservations here?
I pulled some strings through the university. Is it too much? I was going for something different.
Couldn't be more different. And you ordered hors d'oeuvres.
No clue what they are, but they were the hardest thing on the menu to pronounce, so...
Edward, you're...
I need to talk to you, and if I don't do it now, I may lose my nerve.
Okay.
Leah, I can't date you anymore.
Hi, Mom, Dad. What are you doing here?
Leah Townsend, will you marry me?
Things are just as they should be.
Edward, I don't know what to say.
All you have to say is yes.
Yes?
Please come. Yes, sorry.
Well, all I have to say is it's about time. And you're the perfect match for Leah, son, and I mean that.
Oh, thank you, sir.
Leah, we are going to have such fun planning the wedding.
Mom, I just...
Actually, that's something that I wanted to talk to all of you about. My grandmother is turning 98 this year, and she would love nothing more than to be at our wedding. Unfortunately, she's been rather ill this past year, and, well, if it would be all right with you, Leah, then we get married on her birthday.
That's very gallant of you, Edward.
In 3 weeks.
Rather soon. I don't see any reason why we couldn't manage it. Right, Douglas?
But 3 weeks is only 3 weeks away.
You just say when and where, and I'll be the one in the tux.
Great.
Well, okay, I guess the whole 3 weeks it is.
My beautiful bride. In just 3 weeks.
Cheers.
Cheers. Cheers.
Stocking fee. Mm-hmm. Okay.
consider that baby restocked.
Leah, I mean, it's just an exercise. I mean, you're right on the border of losing both grace and dignity.
I'm sorry. I've made a terrible mistake.
No, there are no mistakes in this class. It's just about how we feel.
No, really, seriously. I haven't been honest. I haven't been honest to any of you, like, at all.
Not coming.
Me neither.
I told you she needed this class.
This is a prime example of not handling yourself with dignity or grace when your boyfriend of 2 years proposes to you and you say yes, when in reality you really have no idea how you feel about him, like, at all.
Edward.
Yes. Edward and I have been together for 2 years. He signed. He's the kidney disease stricken second fake cousin. I made up that whole story because I didn't want you guys to know I was being stood up, and then I couldn't leave because I didn't want to disappoint him.
So, naturally, you're gonna marry him?
I'm so sorry. But you have to excuse me, man.
Supposed to call me yesterday to set a time to look at invitation samples today?
Sorry, Mom. I've just been really caught up in the book and
writing. The last time you did this was when you switched from political science to an arts degree, and you were terrified to tell your father. So, this time?
Nothing. Nothing at all. You walked in when I was clearing my head.
Well, honey, maybe I need some head clearing too.
What do you mean? Something with you and Dad?
I didn't tell you this before, but I was dating somebody else when I met your father. He was very nice. His name was Howard. He was in medical school. My father adored him. But the only problem was, I didn't. I liked him, and I just was going to get married. It seemed inevitable. But then I went to a freshman party, and I met this strong-willed, opinionated senior who had his heart set on a precarious career in politics. Dead. Feathers. But I never regretted my decision. Because it was exactly that. My darling, my decision. And I often do things your father's way because I choose to. And what I want you to understand is that I'm happy in my life. But that doesn't mean you have to do the same thing to be happy.
Smarter and more talented than me.
Excellent.
I'll take the next turn, if that's okay.
Welcome back.
I admit I need this class. I'm in an impossible situation. I'm actually going through with this wedding because I can't stop myself. I don't want to hurt Edward, and I don't want to embarrass my father. I can't even disappoint my publisher.
It's good, Leah. It's really good. You got it, okay? Now let's walk through an imaginary confrontation. Okay, I'll be Edward.
I'll do it.
Okay, so whenever you're ready, Leah, just talk from the heart.
Edward, we need to talk.
Is it a...
Yes. I can't marry you.
just not right for each other.
2 years and you're just figuring this out now?
Yes. I'm sorry. But when you start to think about the rest of your life, you want to be sure you do it with the right person.
What kind of person is the right person?
Some. Or at least wants to find out who I really am.
Why did you lie to me?
I told you about the kidney thing.
I knew that was a complete fiction from day one. And I thought it was pretty hilarious. So what I'm hearing is you
tightrope walker who makes it across is the one who knows she doesn't need a net. I'm not going to be your safety net.
Back, Dad, and we'll get into it again.
You're kicking me out.
You like my style?
It's been really nice finally having you on the show, Dad.
It's good to be here.
I'm Cinco Dublin. Come back tomorrow, and we'll talk.
Hi.
What's he doing in my house?
He's with me.
Wait, you're friends with this man?
Actually, he's somebody very special to me, and because of that, I'd like you to give him a chance.
Special? So why would you keep something like this from me?
Because I was afraid you wouldn't approve.
You think you need my approval? Sweetie, I only want you to be happy, hey? We may never, if you care for my daughter. I imagine we're gonna have to learn to get along.
I appreciate that, sir. I do care very much about her.
Good. Well, I just want to say how truly proud because of the success of the wonderful book that you wrote, or because of the fine woman that you are, but because I get to say thank you for being my daughter. Aww. Leah.
Leah.
Sir, may I say something? Thank you. My grandparents were married for 75 years. And the love they shared is something I spent most of my life looking for. The truth is that you can't find love. You can only hide from it. It's family or marriage. Love finds you. My grandfather proposed to my grandmother after only 2 weeks of dating. Now, you're probably not ready to have me propose yet, but I do have a question. Leah Townsend, friend.
Glad to be here, girl.
Got to find